driving my friend Dalton's 3.8 liter Hyundai Genesis. He just put an updated exhaust on it, upgraded exhaust on it. And my, this thing sounds great. You see my truck back there? And it backfires and pops. Let's give it a little roll. I love this Genesis, and it cost at the same price as my truck, which honestly makes me really mad, but he got a hell of a deal on this thing. I love it.
So I don't make it, okay. truck stuff.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, I'll turn off his car. Yeah, I think that was it. Ford, there's a push thing.
Just leave it in.
He doesn't Ford.
I don't five speed either, so I can't deal with it.
Don't tell me you tried to find six.
I did. I'm like, wait a second, this is a five speed. Surprise, you didn't want to go play on the highway.
Oh, well, when you're saying that, well,
no, that's fine.
No, that was an option.
First person in a while to do that.
Sorry.
It's fine.
So I'm sorry guys, this kind of was out of the blue. I didn't expect this to happen. I keep my GoPro in my truck, but not the head strap. So I'm kind of holding the camera as I go. But one thing that I'm driving it, you know, it's got a sunroof. It's got a lot of luxuries my truck does not have. And the sound. One thing I also really like about this car is it's, considering it's an electronic throttle, it's a bit tricky, it's something to get used to, but now that I'm used to it, it's honestly pretty easy to downshift, and it sounds really good doing it too. I really like, you know, it's a 6-speed, so I'm going 80 kilometers an hour, it's about 45 to 50 miles an hour at 1800 RPM. But here's the ease of a rev match downshift in a Genesis 3.8 liter. Fifth. Like, as long as you, because what took me so long is, since my truck has a cable driven throttle, it's direct, so I can take my foot off the clutch and go right onto the gas. Whereas with this car, it's a little hesitant because it's electronic, so when I go to put my foot on the gas after releasing the clutch, like, it takes a second, so it's kind of rougher. It doesn't sound smooth. But when you get used to the delay and you account for the delay when you're driving, which you can subconsciously do, you can rev match as if it was a cable-driven throttle, really. Like, I'll rev match here. I enjoy rev matching, if you can't tell. It's just like a learning curve with anything. I really enjoy this car. Oh, and the burbles and pops. Sorry guys, I don't know if you can even see me right now. I don't know if you can tell I'm excited driving this car. Like, this car costs at the same price as my truck, and you know, I wouldn't never say it's as much fun to drive as the Cobra, but it's a lot of fun. And I also want to give a thank you to Dalton for letting me drive his car and kind of shoot this video. This car is extremely easy to drive, which is good for a car, a sports car in this price range, because a lot of people are going to be learning how to drive manual on a car like this. And it's not hard at all. I've driven quite a few stick cars myself, and this is by far one of the easiest ones to drive. I've driven the 2-liter turbo version of this car, and as well like this, the 3.8 liter. And the 2-liter turbo feels a lot lighter, I'm sure because of the engine, and the one I drove was really a base model with no leather seats, no sunroof, nothing like that. So this has a lot of added extras for luxury and performance, which adds a lot of weight. But the engine pulls it through, Whereas 2-liter turbo really, really, really relied on the turbo to pull it through. Where that car, you can feel the turbo spool up because of the lack of torque down low. And then once you start putting your foot onto the throttle, you can feel it start building torque through the turbo. Whereas with this car, you have it all the time. 6th gear, 2 grand. And it picks up speed, honestly, not much faster than my truck. So, I think it's time to enjoy it on the highway. All right, well, you have my thoughts on the Genesis 3.8 liter. I'm gonna enjoy the ride now, and I will catch up to you guys once I'm done.
I mean, look at it, it's a different fucking color. It's yeah. Also textured.
How's the truck? Both of you drove it.
I want one.
It's daily as fuck.
Okay. Because I was saying that to my video, that it's not throttle response, like its response is bad.
Well, I mean, remember last time you drove it, you couldn't fast shift it at all, though.
Yeah.
I don't think it's the car. I sincerely think it's your...
What am I doing wrong?
You're like, not supposed to be...
You're treating it like a Mustang.
You're not supposed to be nice to it.
No,
it makes peak power at 63.
So just shift it high.
Don't give him a
thought. But that's not with throttle response. Like if I'm rev match downshifting, it's not instant. Not compared to that. That is more responsive because it's cable driven.
It's cable.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
You're going to get that in any car.
Yeah.
It's electric.
No, That's what I'm saying. I even was saying that the Civic might be more responsive than that. Might have them.
Do you want to do it? Because I feel like...
Okay, I'm not trying to insult you. If it's my driving, it's my driving.
I'll take the criticism.
Okay, okay, if I knew I could be f***ing hard on it, I would have been f***ing hard on it.
Yeah. I got buying new tires anyway, so don't worry about it.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Trust me, I can break these tires at like 3,000 now. But like I said, that thing, you can just hang it. There you go.
Used to the Genesis. So anyways, I got a little carried away driving Dalton's Genesis, but man, is that car fun. I love my truck, and I always get so excited, and then I rev it a little bit, and it like does a few little backfires, and I'm like, oh yeah, my truck sounds great, and then I hear it from outside, and I see it from outside, and I'm like, you have to really be paying attention to think that the truck sounds good and looks good, honestly, but it's clean for what it is. I feel like I am getting sidetracked. So, Dalton's car though is so loud. The volume and the pops and the burbles and the power. He paid like 600 and something for the exhaust. Like,
for this truck, it's about $350 for an exhaust, not bad. But for the Mustangs, it's like $2,000 for an exhaust system. He improved the volume to his car for $600, which is not bad at all, especially for that sound. And like I said earlier, he paid the same price that I paid for this. So I'm kind of every time I see that car, I'm scratching my head. I'm like, man, I kind of wish I had that. That's just what car guys do. That's what we do. We see other people with cars or our friends with cars, and we want what they have because we don't have it. But I really love that car. And like I said, I've driven the 2-liter before, and the 3.8 is a huge step up from the 2-liter. And I kept trying to compare the Genesis to my truck. You can't. Like, this is a 6-cylinder truck, 5-speed. It's Ford, cable-driven throttle. Whereas the Genesis is also a 6-cylinder, but it's not American. The throttle is electric. It's a 6-speed. It's just a different car. It's more of a sports car. It's just different. I can't compare them, and I can't compare it to the Civic either. It's a car of its own, and it's so easy to drive, and I'm still kind of like heads in the clouds about it. That car, so much fun. I really kind of wish I had one, but you know what they say. But I'm sure the novelty on my truck will come back once I get a lift and some wheels and tires and clean it up a bit more. But until then, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this kind of impromptu video, and I'll talk to you guys in the next